Hey guys, what's up? My name is Beatbreaker, and in today's video I'm gonna show you guys how to get the best possible visual quality on your live stream if you're using an NVIDIA graphics card. So since the last video that I made on this very topic, there has been a number of improvements to the NVENC implementation. So first of all, we had improvements to the actual physical implementation of NVENC on NVIDIA graphics cards. So with the new Turing cards, we have much better visual quality at much lower performance drop. And at the same time, we also have improvements to the way that OBS is actually using NVENC, giving you even more performance. But if you're interested in the exact gains that you can expect going from the old NVENC implementation to the new one, as well as going from a 10 series graphics cards to a 20 series graphics cards, then definitely check out the video in the card right now, where I go into a deep dive into every different bitrate, every different resolution that you can imagine, and look at how performance and visual quality bodes compared to X264 at various presets. Now, luckily, as of a few weeks ago, these improvements to the NVENC encoder have also been introduced into Streamlabs OBS. So this video is valid for both Streamlabs OBS and OBS Studio. And with that, let's jump right into the video. First of all, you want to make sure to update to the latest version of either OBS Studio or Streamlabs OBS. OBS Studio, the latest version is, at the point of filming, 23.1, and for Streamlabs OBS, the latest version is 0.12.3. So the first thing I usually like to do is to set up a new profile in order to be able to go back to the old settings if you don't like these new settings. So go to Profile, New, and give it some very creative name. Done that, let's hop over to the Settings, go to the Video tab, and make sure to enter as base resolution the actual native resolution of your monitor. You always want to have this to match the resolution that you're playing your games at, because you don't want to do any scaling in the canvas, because it will look basically very bad. So just enter your monitor's resolution. In my case, this will be 1440p. For output resolution, I have a table on screen showing my recommended output resolution depending on your upload speed. We will come back to the upload speed in just a second, but just take this as a brief estimation, and basically you can choose anything between 720p and 1080p here, although I usually like to use 900p, which obviously is not existent in this list here, but you can just type it in manually. Downscale filter, you definitely want to choose Lanczos, as this provides the best visual quality, as I've tested in this video. And finally, FPS, once again, kind of depends on your upload speed. If you have very poor upload speed, then you might need to stick to 30 FPS, but if you have anything above like 5 or 6 megabits per second, you should be fine to stick to 60 FPS. Next, let's hop over to the Stream tab, where you can specify which kind of streaming service you'd like to use. Now, if you want to stream to Twitch, then you can actually connect your account here to your Twitch account, which will then allow you to show you your chat in OBS Studio, as well as change the title and kind of the tags of the current live stream. Now, if you do not want to connect your Twitch account, or if you want to use other services, then you need to enter your stream key here. Now, you can find your Twitch stream key by going to the Creator dashboard, where on the channel page, you'll find your private stream key. For YouTube, go to youtube.com/live_dashboard, scroll all the way to the bottom where you'll find your YouTube stream key. And finally for Facebook, go to your Facebook page, click on Live, click on Connect, and there you'll find your Facebook stream key. Now, if you plan on streaming to Twitch, you can also select which kind of server you want to stream to. Now, to figure out which kind of server is best in your specific case, you should most definitely download the Twitch Bandwidth Test Tool. Link to this is in the description below, which helps you pick the best server. So in order to use this tool, enter your stream key, enter automatic OBS in TCP window size, use the short test duration, because otherwise it's going to take forever, and make sure to select the region where you're actually based in. Click on Start and let the test proceed. Next, you'll select the server with the lowest ping, so this is the round trip time, as well as the highest quality. In my case, this is going to be Italy, Milan. Now, if you do have zero quality here in the last column, then you've either mistakenly entered stars instead of your actual stream key. If you did enter your stream key, then try to reset it. So go to your dashboard, hit reset, copy it again, enter it, and try again. Or it can also be that you just have such a low bandwidth, I think something below 2000 or 3000, that this tool basically just gives you zero quality because of your low upload speed. Now also make sure to write down the bandwidth that you're getting in this test here, because we're going to be using it for the next step. Now onto the output tab, which is probably the main reason why most of you clicked on this video. You obviously want to use the output mode advanced, use the first audio track, and then obviously you want to make sure to use the NVIDIA NVENC encoder new. Now you might have noticed that the rescale output option has just disappeared once we selected the new NVENC encoder. Now the reason for that is that rescale output here was using the CPU to downscale or rescale the video. And because the new NVENC encoder keeps the frames on the GPU, it's no longer possible to rescale output. If you must rescale output, you are not able to use the new NVENC encoder and gonna have to resort to using the old NVENC implementation. Next, make sure to disable enforced streaming service encoding settings, because, well, we know what settings we want to put in and we don't want this to mess up our settings. As rate control, you always want to use CBR, so constant bit rate, and on to the bit rate. Now, once again, I'm showing this table on screen where you can see my recommended bit rate depending on your potential upload speed. Obviously, you want to use this as an estimate and then try out for yourself which kind of bit rate is actually feasible depending on the game that you're playing and on the upload that you have. Obviously, which kind of bitrate you select also depends on the resolution that you'd like to stream at, and it also depends on the streaming service that you'd like to use. With YouTube, you can use much higher bitrates, as all of the video on all of the live stream rather are always re-encoded on YouTube themselves, whereas on Twitch, you have to stick to the recommended bitrate. Now, I put the link to the recommended bitrates in the description below. Now, let's assume that you're using Twitch and have somewhat decent upload. So let's stick to 6000 kilobits per second. The keyframe interval basically defines how often a uncompressed image is sent to the streaming service. Basically, you always want to set this to 2. Now for preset, you always want to use max quality unless you have encoding overload, in which case you might want to reduce to quality. Profile, leave at high and disable look ahead. Now what this option does is it basically determines dynamically how many B frames you're going to be using. But usually if live streaming, you'll want to set max B frames to 2 anyways and disable this option because, well, you have such a low bitrate that using this option doesn't really make sense. Now let's talk about Psycho Visual Tuning. Now this option is kind of hit or miss. It basically tries to improve visual quality by reducing the amount of macro blocking that's going on in the video. So basically, if you have a lot of macro blocks that you'd like to get rid of, then try to enable this option. But on the other hand, this option leads to an overall decrease in visual quality, which is why I usually just like to disable it altogether. Note that both Look Ahead and Psycho Visual Tuning are using CUDA cores in order to operate. So if you're already maxed out on GPU usage, absolutely disable both options unless you want to risk running into encoding overload. Finally, GPU you want to set to 0, so that is just your main GPU. And usually I would really not recommend to use a second GPU to do the encoding with, because with the new NVENC encoder, what you're basically gonna do is you're gonna fall back to the old implementation of NVENC, as the frames have to get transferred from your GPU RAM to the actual RAM of your PC and then back onto the second GPU, pretty much removing all the performance benefit that this new implementation brought. In the audio tab, I usually just select the standard 160 kilobits per second. And finally, in the replay buffer, I usually disable the replay buffer. Next, let's head over to the audio tab, where first of all, you want to match the sample rate in OBS Studio to the actual sample rate that you have in Windows. So to determine your sample rate, go to the speaker icon, right-click on it, click on Sounds. Now go to your recording and playback devices, right-click on them, click on Properties, click on Advanced, and check which kind of sample rate you're using here. Make sure that this matches the sample rate in OBS Studio. As desktop audio device, use your regular playback device, and as mic, your regular mic. I do not have any other audio devices, and I don't touch any of these settings. And finally, in the Advanced tab, you want to have Process Priority Normal. Color format, you want to use the standard NV12. And YUV color space, you want to use 709 with the YUV color range full. Now on screen, I show the difference between 709, 609 and the original in the middle. And as you can see, 709 produces the most accurate color representation compared to the original clip. If you want to, you can enable a stream delay, but I usually just leave this unchecked as I like as fast as possible interaction with my viewers. But that's it, those are pretty much the settings to get the best possible quality on your livestream. If something is still unclear or you have any other questions, then don't hesitate to leave them in the comments down below. But that is it for today's video, guys. If you like this video, smash that like button, preferably an uneven amount of numbers. Subscribe for more content like this. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.